And so we begin another episode of Tech of Tomorrow. In today's video, I'm going to tell you guys 10 reasons why I think you should consider a Mac over a PC. And before you go crazy and leave the brutal comments down in the comment section below, I asked you to just watch the video and follow along and then give me your opinions at the end. So let's go! 10 reasons why you should consider a Mac. Did you just buy a brand new computer or upgrade your old computer with so many parts it's now asking for a new Windows key and you don't have one? Well, check this out. VIP Your CD Key has you covered and you don't have to pay Bill Gates that $199 price tag at all. You can get it right now for under $25 and it's easier than ever to do. All you do is you go over to the website. On their website, you create an account. After that, you go and find your software. You put your software in the cart, enter the code TOT20. It will give you a wonderful 25% discount. You go to the checkout. After you do the checkout, check your email a couple of minutes later. You will have the code in there. Put it in your computer and activate your computer. It's that simple. And check it out. All of these codes are guaranteed for life. So save yourself some money and check out the links below. All right, sorry for the silly intro. So check this out. 10 reasons why you may want to consider getting an Apple-based Mac computer and not buying a PC. Now, first off, all of the new Apple Silicon processors are way ahead of their time. These are the most advanced and most powerful processors you can get for the desktop market. I don't care what you want to say, argue, Intel, AMD, Mama's Kitchen, none of them can touch it. They have the absolute best processors on the market. And before you cry about them not playing games with Rosetta and other things, you can play games on a Mac. There are plenty of games now that you can play without any problem whatsoever because the graphics on these things are actually very, very strong. So that's reason number one. Let's just face it. If you have the best silicon, you have the best CPU-GPU combination, that's something to consider, right? Number two, viruses, they just don't exist in the Mac environment at all. When you have an Apple computer, you don't have to worry about checking your email and stuff and worrying about getting viruses. For some reason, people just don't write them for Mac computers. And even though maybe they may exist, I've never seen one in all of the years that I've been using one for 15 now that I have not ever seen a virus on it ever. And guess what? You don't have to waste money on buying fucking, guess what? Virus protection. You don't have to buy that shit ever. Never, ever, 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 never. You don't have to worry about it. So that's another thing to consider, especially if you're somebody who checks their email a lot or does a lot of work on the web. You might want the protection that you're getting from an Apple-based computer. Now, number three, some people would probably consider the number one reason, even though I have it as the third. That's just how I have it actually written out. A lot of people might consider this the number one reason to have an Apple and Mac-based computer. But the reason that I didn't call it number one is because, well, not everybody out there is going to agree with this because of this particular reason. Now, if you have an iPhone, an iPad, and you work already in that Appleverse, then having a PC makes really no sense at all. It really doesn't. For one thing, with your iPhone, with your iPad, you can seamlessly integrate these things directly to your computer. So you take pictures on your phone, you do whatever on your phone, instantly can have it going and migrating over to your computer. You don't have to do any transferring or anything else. It's automatically over there. If you have files you want to send over there, you have something you've saved on your iPad that you want on your computer to work on later, you can seamlessly do this. You don't have to email it. It just, you can just slash it over. And with the new mirroring option that they have for your phone, it's even cooler. You can really just completely mirror everything that you're doing on your phone on your Mac computer. And that's just a better ecosystem all around than the PC environment. But like I said, if you use an Android phone, this isn't going to matter to you whatsoever. And that's why I made it number 3 instead of number 1. So don't take a number 2 on me. Now, number 4, the days of Macs and Apple computers being completely overpriced, those days are out the window. Macs and Apple computers, especially in the desktop environment, are very, very competitively priced, and they have refurb models that are even cheaper. I bought a laptop a few weeks ago. It was only $300 and something. It runs all my keyboards and does everything I want and integrates perfectly with the rest of my Mac stuff, and I'm totally happy with it. So if you're looking for a desktop, they have all kinds of stuff going on. They have iMacs, they have Mac Minis, which honestly, guys, a Mac Mini has been running my business now for years. It used to be an iMac when they first came out, but now it's a Mac Mini. So both my recording studio and my filming studio are all run on a little Mac Mini that isn't even that much to buy for an entry-level computer. Now, number 5, this has to do with laptops. When you have an Intel laptop and you unplug it, the CPU throttles down. You're not getting the full power and performance of it because it throttles down to save power. When you're using any of the Apple Mac laptops, your CPU is running at the full power the entire time until it dies, giving you maximum power in your portable machine. Now, number 6 is much better technical support. When you buy an Apple Mac computer, you get way better support. It's easy to get somebody on the phone. It's easy to help somebody go through your computer virtually and find out exactly what's going on with your computer, get it fixed. If you have the Apple warranty, which I would always suggest getting because it's awesome. If anything happens to your computer, you just send it back and they send you a new one. And if they don't have the same old model that you had, guess what? You luck out and you get a newer model automatically. Now, number 7 is free software updates forever. Once you buy software on a Mac, you never have to pay for any updates ever again. You buy Logic, it updates forever free. You buy Final Cut, it updates forever for free. Any of the software you buy on the Apple Store that's for your Mac for a workflow, all the updates are free. Your OS, free. No more buying copies of Windows, no more trying to get serial numbers, any of that stuff. You just don't need it. In the Apple ecosystem, you're taken care of. Once you pay, it's yours forever. No additional moolah. Now, number 8 is Macs are just totally better in a recording studio and in a video studio. For one thing, they're just way more stable. You don't want to spend time setting up all these cameras, doing all this stuff. Even in a simple environment like mine, you don't want to lose all that information and have to go back and refilm all that crap and re-audio tape it and everything else and then get it all back together again. You just don't want to do that. And all the recording studios I've been to all use a Mac of one type or another. They all do. Whether they're using the old big old towers for old school guys who are using just old school stuff, those are still in existence all the way down to what I use in my recording studio. I use a very pretty much a high-end Mac Mini. It's pretty decked out, but it runs the recording studio perfectly. No noise. It's completely silent. It doesn't get hot. All the software is completely fine. I don't have glitches. I don't have shutdowns. I do get a little pinwheel sometimes when the computer gets, overwhelmed, but it doesn't shut down, make you restart, or freeze up. It doesn't do any of that type of stuff, which to me is just a way better workflow because you don't have to worry about what you're working on getting lost when your PC freezes up or just stops working or makes you reboot right in the middle of your project that you're trying to get done. That shit just sucks. All right, so I have to admit, number 8 kind of does roll into number 9. I probably should have separated that because number 9 is stability. When you buy a Mac, an Apple, when you buy anything from their laptops to their desktops to anything else, the stability in these machines is just much better. There's a reason that the Unix system that's inside of a Mac is used by NASA, it's used by Elon and X. Nobody uses a PC when they're trying to go into space. It's just not stable enough. But the system that all Macs are based off of is a Unix-based system, which is like Red Hat Linux and all these others that are out there. So stability is like really mind-bogglingly much better than on a PC. It just doesn't freeze up on you. It doesn't lock up on you. You know, like I said before, once in a while you'll get a little pinwheel that just says that right now, you know, your memory and stuff is being overloaded because you have too many plugins going, but it balances out and moves forward. It doesn't just lock up, freeze up, and make you lose your project. And that's one thing that I feel is a very, very strong thing about all of the Macs in general. Here is number 10. If you have a young child and they are getting their first computer, an Apple Macintosh computer is so much more straightforward and easy to use that I would seriously recommend it as a first computer to any kid unless all they're trying to do is be a gamer. If all they want to do is be a gamer, then sure, buy them some PC and spend all your money and jump on down that rabbit hole. I did it before, I understand. It's totally cool. But if you're looking for something for your child to be doing education, schoolwork, this type of stuff, guess what? Macs are great for this. And they have laptops that are unbelievably cheap that are more stable and better than a PC. So for a first computer, I think that number 10 is definitely the fact that I feel that for a first computer for a child or someone just having their first computer, a Mac is just so much easier. It's easier to navigate. It's easier to use. Like I said before, it's stable. You know, actually, you can almost take, you know, 1 through 8 or 1 through 9, and they all apply to 10 as well, because who knows what that kid's going to do with that first computer. And because of all of those things that I stated previously, this is why I feel that that would be the best computer for somebody who's getting their first computer, like I said, unless all they want to do is game. So I'm Elric. I thank you guys for watching Tech of Tomorrow once again. Thanks for being here. Like usual, hey, I'd appreciate it if you guys would like and share this video. I have links down below to my Patreon account, to my music. So if you guys want to help support the channel, you can donate a single dollar to my Patreon channel and keep me going. So I'd appreciate that. Love you guys. See you back here. Love to see your comments. Remember, don't be rude. We're all here to learn together. Love you.